I got a call from the dean of admissions asking if you were to get into Harvard, would you accept? And I said yes, because I knew my mom would kill me if I said anything else.
The first few weeks, I made some of my best friends, but two of us were sexually assaulted before classes had even started.
I went to the dean of students' office, and she said, I just want to make sure that you don't talk to anyone about this.
They protect perpetrators because they have a financial incentive to do so.
The problem of sexual assault on campuses is enormous.
I think it's fair to say that they cover these crimes up.
There's a lot of victim blaming.
He lectured us about how we shouldn't go out in short skirts.
They told me, despite the fact that I had a written admission of guilt, that I presented to them could only prove that he loved me.
They discourage them from going to the police. If it goes to the police, then it's more likely to end up as a public record.
Universities are protecting a brand.
The campus police cannot contact an athlete.
He won the Heisman Trophy with his DNA rape kit.
Just sit down with the students and ask them, where are the hot spots?
SAE, sexual assault expected.
The second most common type of insurance claim against the fraternity industry is for rape.
Her rapist's name matched the name of two other cases, and he was allowed back on campus.
The message is clear, you're not gonna win.
We started seeing, you know, what was happening at campuses across the country.
Hi.
Hi, has no one connected the dots before?
These students went from sexual assault victims to survivors and now activists.
My name is Carolyn Luby.
My name is Alexa Schwartz.
My name is Ari Mostov.
This is a national problem.
I was getting threatened. It was working in their favor to silence me, and I was terrified.
I thought if I told them, they would take action, but the only action they took was against me.
We've got a lot further to go.